Hi students, coming to the next subject, that is the HTML. So this HTML is the client-side scripting language. The one thing you have to be remember that it is client-side scripting language. Client-side scripting language. This is not a programming language. It is a client-side scripting language. Actually, this is used, means that is, it is used for static web pages. It is used to design static web pages. That is, used to design static web pages. So, what exactly this HTML was? HTML. HTML means hyper. H means hyper. T means text, M means markup, L is language. HTML means hypertext markup language. Hyper is nothing but it's just a link. You call it as a reference or a link. It is a link to where you have to navigate. So that is a hyperlink. And next, text is nothing but the data or information. So whatever the data that you want to be displayed, that information will be explained in the form of text. And what about the markup? Markup is nothing but it's a predefined terms, a predefined statement somewhere present in this HTML language. And what about the language? Language is used for communication. So if you want to communicate, you need some language. So this is a hypertext markup language. So the thing is, whenever you are asked about what is HTML, HTML is a hypertext markup language, and explain what is this each term refers to. Hyper means reference link, text is nothing but a data, markup is a predefined, and wherever the language is nothing but communication. So HTML is not a programming language. So I already said, it is not a programming language, just like Java, C. So like that, it's not a programming language. Just it is a markup language. We call it as markup language. The markup language is a set of markup tags. So in this markup language, you are having set of markup tags. That means this markup language consisting of the syntax that consisting of everything in the form of tags, set of tags will be present. So this hypertext markup language consists of markup tags. That complete language is in the form of tags. The markup tags are used to describe the web pages. So these markup tags used to describe web pages. Okay, so don't be confused. HTML is not a programming language. You just call it as a markup language. What exactly that markup language consists of? Whereas programming language is in the form of English like sentence, whereas markup language is just a set of markup tags. It is in the form of markup tags. So what that markup tags consist of? It is that markup tags is used to describe the web pages. So here, whatever the web page that you want to design, that every web page is designed in every web page designed as HTML has an extension. It was saved in the form of extension like .html or .html. So whatever the program you are writing, that is in the form of tags, that should be saved by using the extension .html or .htm. Okay, so where you write these HTML programs? So we will, the editor, we use it to design this HTML static web pages, or you can use Notepad or Notepad++. So either you use these editor or Notepad++ editor to write the HTML language. And here whenever you have written that, you just save it as .html or .htm. Here, every HTML script will be executed in any web browser. So finally, it will be executed on. It is executed in any web browser. Okay, so this hypertext markup language, whenever you save that, it will be executed in any web browser. So let me write a simple syntax of this HTML. I said that HTML is a markup language. It is not a programming language. The markup language consisting of markup tags. So this is a tags representation. Doc type HTML. First, let me write the program. After that, I'll explain what exactly these tags are. My first heading, and then this is one of the tag paragraph. My first paragraph, close the body, close HTML. So this is a markup language. So what these tags represents? So here the doc type HTML is nothing but declaration of it's just declaration defining the document type. It's nothing but whatever the text you are writing is document type of text we are writing. So that is a representation here. And whatever the statements that you are writing, that should be started with the open tag and this should be the close tag. So this is the HTML. This is the starting HTML. End of the statements you have to close by using the backslash. Okay. So this is a text between, whatever the text between the HTML describes the web page. So in between this HTML open and the close, whatever the text that is present in between the tags describes web page. Describes the web page. Then what about this body? So here, whatever the body that is consisting of open starting tag and ending tag of the body. So this body here, the text between the body, whatever the text that is present between the body is a visible page content. Is the visible page. So you are able to see this information. What is present inside the body is visible page. You can see on the screen, visible page content. And what about this h1? So this is the starting tag and ending tag. The text between the h1 is displayed as a heading. So this is heading. So the heading will be from h1 to h6. And this p tag is represents the paragraph. A text between this paragraph displays the a paragraph. Okay, so this is just an introduction part of the hypertext markup language. Thank you.